Hi, I'm Fred Sauer. I'm a developer advocate with Google, and I have today with me three guys with a great idea, great application that they built on top of App Engine, and we'd like to talk about that today. So maybe you guys can start with how you chose App Engine, and did you evaluate any alternatives? Just go ahead, walk us through the thought process.
So just to give you a little background, basically what we have done is we've created Socialwok, right? And you can check out socialwok.com. It's basically a cloud service for enterprise social. And because of that, we want to do everything in the cloud, right? And we looked at alternatives like could be EC2, Amazon's EC2 and S3. And we also possibly look at our own server colos. But end of the day, we settled on App Engine because we felt that it was highly scalable, right? It enabled us to, at very low cost, to create a web application very quickly and host it on, in this case, App Engine Java on Google. And we don't have to worry too much about the scaling up, right? And because it's based on Google infrastructure and we are selling as a small startup, enterprise tool, we could always leverage on Google's security functionalities and your scalability arguments, and that allowed us to go to market quite nicely.
In short, I always say this, is that we're software developers, not system administrators, and Google Apps, App Engine actually allowed us to be just that, software developers.
Another thing we use the Java language support for App Engine, and the great thing about that is that while we don't really want to move off App Engine, we love it, we think it's great. We like developing with the flexibility of being able to say, we can move this off, and that's really why we chose the App Engine Java language support. We believe that Google is right on in saying you should be able to move stuff off of our infrastructure as part of their new initiatives and things like that. So what we're Our view is that we're probably going to stick with App Engine, and then we'll always have one or two customers who are going to say, let's we want to move it off.
Just a quick add to what Naveen, enterprise portability, especially in our space, because in enterprise, people like to have portability as an option, and I think what App Engine Java offers is very key. And lastly, also for developers, you have free coders. What's not to like about free coders? That allows you to test your app adoption. So I would highly encourage everyone, if you're doing any cloud application and you want data portability, you want security, and you want to be as close to the enterprise stack as possible, I would say App Engine Java is the way to go.
Maybe you can share your thoughts on a distributed data store versus a traditional relational model. How has that worked for you, and what advice do you maybe have for other developers thinking about a transition?
So the thing is, it really does require you to change your mindset when you're going in. Most people, when they use the traditional tools, they're using joins. It's famous. What's famous about the App Engine data store is the data store does not support joins. So that's almost one of the first things you have to start changing how you program stuff. You start thinking about how do I normalize these things, break them down into multiple queries. Also, one of the things that we actually look at is there's certain niceties about the way App Engine indexes certain entities. One of the things that when you start developing is you realize that all queries are based on indexes that you have to define in your application. Well, one of the beauties of these indexes is that many of these indexes can contain multiple values. So a lot of times you can basically perform queries that are very optimal that allow you to do a lot of powerful things. You just have to kind of work your way around it, realize it. And one of the great things about App Engine is there's a lot of great documentation, videos, demonstrations, things that basically automatically that are already tell you, there are these things out there, you should check them out. So that's sort of how we kind of got around these things.
Okay. Would you describe, say, the distributed model as more complicated than the relational model? Or how would you compare the two?
So it's very different. It's very different. It can be complex when you start dealing with certain things like atomicity and item potency. When you start getting into those areas, it gets very complex. But from the initial point of view, it's more about changing how you basically write stuff. So much of the code that you write normally in the first place is not that complex per se. It's just a little bit of a different way around a certain problem. And so once you kind of get that, you can develop pretty quickly. Then when you want to sort of start working on the complicated things, item potency, things like consistency, transactions are a good example of things that work differently on App Engine. the App Engine data store than they do in normal relational databases, that's when things start to get complex and you'll start thinking about really developing in a very strict way.
Okay. Are there things about the App Engine data store that are actually easier than on a relational database? Things that you could do now that may be harder to get to perform correctly in a relational world?
It's hard to say that. One of the things that I pointed out earlier is the multi-valued nature of the indexing. So one of the cool things about the App Engine data store is it supports multi-valued properties. So multi-valued properties in Java basically show up as collections, list. So a lot of times we refer to them as list properties, if you're familiar with the Python. Or in Java, it's more collection properties, things like that, of that nature. So those things are really, really cool because you can actually do queries on those properties just like you do queries on single value properties. And that actually can do a lot of very scalable, optimal things. And it's not that hard to really, code that stuff up. It might be a little bit weird to sort of look at those queries. But.
And if you don't really want to get into, too much complexity, you can always just use JDO, and which is a familiar concept to most Java enterprise developers, and your app would still work fine.
Okay. Can you talk maybe about some of your other experiences with the platform to date?
So a couple of other experiences we've seen is we're pretty much at the cutting edge of most stuff. So as soon as things get released, we tend to start using those features, things like the task queues, which are really, really useful. For us, especially an app like as complex as us, we need to do things that run in the background that don't affect the user. A couple of other things that we've run into, we had to actually implement our own search engine on App Engine, and while it seems kind of weird to say that Google is a search company, they don't have full text search on the data store, we know that's complex, and what we've done is we've basically gotten around those problems using some of the things that Google themselves have already sort of provided. So.
I'd like to add, from a developer point, when you develop, you run into problems, right? So to date, our experience with App Engine has been great. The IRC channels are a good example. You guys have impromptu chats. Your forums are not bad. You have a lot of knowledge base there. But I also want to add that, for example, for Socialwok's case, right, we actually gave a talk at Googleplex not too long ago for the Silicon Valley JUG. And we were fortunate to be able to invite Max Ross. He's an actual developer on the Google App Engine Java data store team, right? So that level of accessibility and interaction, you can't really get anywhere else, truly.
Okay, great. Well, thank you for your feedback, and thanks for talking with us today.
Thank you.
Thank you.